Good morning, children. Now, in the previous classes, we have learnt about clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Now, let's move on to the transfer of heat. How the heat is transferred from one object to the other. Now, have you observed a frying pan kept on the flame becomes hot? Why is it so? The heat from the flame passes to the utensil, so it becomes hot. Now, when it is removed from the fire, how do we feel? After some time, it cools down. Why is it so? The heat from the utensil is transferred to its surroundings. So, we can say that the heat is transferred from the hotter object to the colder object. Now, this can be shown by an activity also. Now, take a rod or a flat metal strip. So, any metal of aluminium, iron or copper. Now, fix that rod horizontally on a stand, or you can place the rod in between two bricks. Now, place some wax pieces. Wax pieces means candle. Wax pieces at an equal distance on the rod. Now, heat the free end of the rod. Observe what happens. After some time, the rod is a metal. It gets heated up. Now, do the wax pieces fall down? Yes, which wax piece falls down first? So, if we observe that the heat is transferred from the flame to the other end. Now, the wax piece which is nearest to the flame falls down first. That shows that the heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end. So, we can say this, the process by which heat is transferred from the hotter object to the colder object is called conduction. Usually, so what is conduction? The transfer of heat from the hotter object to the colder object is called conduction. Usually in solids, the transfer of heat takes place by conduction. Now, do you think all the substances like plastic, wood and the metals transfer heat by conduction? Let us see. Take some hot water in a beaker. Now, collect some articles like steel spoon, like divider made of steel, and a plastic scale, and a pencil which is made of wood. You know that. So, dip all these articles in the hot beaker. Now, after some times, remove all the articles and observe how do all these articles feel. Touch the other end of the articles. Now, how do we feel the steel spoon? We feel the steel spoon hot, and even the divider also will be hot. And what about the pencil and the plastic scale? So the heat has not passed through wood and plastic scale. So we can say this, the materials which allow heat to pass through them are poor conductors of heat. So they are called conductors. So which are the conductors here? The metal, the spoon which is made of steel, it is a conductor. It allows heat from the hot water to pass through them. So what are conductors? Conductors are those materials which allow heat to pass through them. And there are some materials which do not allow heat to pass through them. They are poor conductors of heat. So they are called insulators. So examples of insulators are plastic and wood. So we have learned that transfer of heat in solids takes place by conduction. Thank you.